Welcome to the St. Peter's Engineering College, Department of Civil Engineering. Myself, Gajendra, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering. I'm going to be teaching the subject surveying and geomatics. So in this, today's session, I'm going to be discussing about the direction measurements. So in this direction measurements, I want to discuss about the forward bearing. Backward bearing, measurement of included angles. So in the direction measurement, so the today's session I'm going to be discussing about the forward bearing, backward bearing, measurement of included angle. So what is meant by the forward bearing, what is meant by the backward bearing, and so how we can able to measure the included angle from the bearings itself. So before going for the forward bearing, backward bearing and measurement of included angles, just I will go for the recap what is meant by the bearing and what is meant by the magnetic bearing and how the bearings are going to be measured. So the bearings are the three types. So bearings are the three types. One is true bearing, TB. This is a TB. Magnetic bearing, MB. Arbitrary bearing, AB. So magnetic bearing, AB, and arbitrary bearing, AB. So true bearing. True bearing is going to be getting the direction from the true meridian. True meridian is the reference direction. From the true meridian, whatever the bearings we are going to measure, then we are going to be called as true bearing, or we are going to be called as this one, we are also going to be called as a azimuth. So true bearing, or we are going to be called as azimuth. So magnetic bearing, for this we are going to be taking as a magnetic needle. So as a reference point, freely suspended magnetic needle. So that is going to be gives that the direction of a line, that we are going to be called as a magnetic bearing. Arbitrary bearing is any reference point, any reference direction we are going to be taking for temporary purpose, and we are going to be completing the measurement of the directions and bearings, that we are going to be called as arbitrary bearing, temporary purpose, time being on a particular day. So we are going to be taking that the reference direction. So that reference direction is going to be temporary purpose. With that reference direction, any reference direction, we are going to be measuring the bearing, we are going to be called as arbitrarily. That's why we are going to be called as arbitrary bearing. So this is about the bearing. Bearing always is going to be giving that the direction of a line, which direction the line is going to be goes. From there, we are going to be measuring that the distances with the tape, and also we are going to be measuring the bearing. So, and also with that bearing, we are going to be so calculating that the angles. So that's why it is going to be called as indirect method of measurement of the angles by using that the bearings. So this is about the bearing. So now after understanding the concept of the bearing, so now we are going for the what is meant by the forward bearing and what is meant by the backward bearing. Forward bearing. So the forward bearing, the term itself is going to be giving is the in forward direction. The direction is going to be called a starting point to the end point. So in the for forward direction, the bearing is going to be measured with respect to the magnetic needle, or we are taking the magnetic north. Magnetic north is going to be considered, because freely suspended NAND needle, always it is showing, always it is going to be showing that the magnetic NAND. That's why compass. Compass always is, so we are going to be take it out for the direction purpose, which is the north direction. From that, once you are identify the north direction, then we know that the south direction, east and west directions itself. So you can able to see that each and every map are drawing. So the top right hand corner, they are going to be showing that in the drawing sheets, top right hand direction, right hand side, top right hand corner, we can able to see that the north direction. So like that in the, so they will show this, the symbol is going to be showing that the north direction. Any drawing, if you take that one map or the drawing, they will show that the top right hand corner. So we can able to see that the north direction. So for that is the purpose, we can able to identify the direction. From that direction, that is going to be giving as a reference. Reference, how we are going to move, moving. Whether the north direction or the south direction, eastward or the westward direction, we are going to be moving. So that is the main objective. We are going to be identifying that the direction. So from the direction, we are going to be getting that the, so from the magnetic needle or the magnetic north, we are going to be measuring that the direction. So that is going to be used as a bearing. That's why we are going to call magnetic bearing. So magnetic bearing comes under the magnetic north by the freely suspended magnetic needle of a prismatic compass. Now forward bearing. So forward bearing of the line is, so this is north. So from A to B, from A to B, so this is the magnetic north. A to B, the line is going to be moved. The direction is going to be A to B. Then there, this one we are going to be called theta 1 degrees is going to be called as a bearing. From the magnetic north, I am going to be measuring the, as so the angle that we are going to be called as bearing. So direction is from A to B. So this is in the forward direction. The direction is going to be called as in the forward direction. So forward direction, the starting point to the end point, we are going to be moving. So that's why we are going to be called as a forward bearing. FB equals to theta 1 degrees. Similarly, in the reverse direction of the line AB is going to be called as a backward bearing. The backward bearing is going to be called as in the backward direction of AB. So I'm going to be measuring that the bearing we are going to be called as backward bearing. This forward bearing is a forward direction. Now, next one is going to be called as, opposite one is going to be called as backward bearing. So backward bearing is the backward direction. So this theta 2 degrees. Theta 2 degrees is the backward bearing of the line AB in the backward direction. So this is in the forward direction. This is forward bearing. So this is backward bearing. So that backward bearing equals to theta 2 degrees in the backward direction of line AB. So forward direction of AB is going to be called as forward bearing, that is theta 1 degrees. Backward direction of the line AB, we are going to be measuring, this is the angle we are going to be measuring. So that is the theta 2 degrees is going to be called as backward bearing. That's why the name is going to be called as backward bearing. The term itself is going to be giving the meaning. Backward bearing is, so the backward direction of a line measuring with reference to the magnetic north. So then we are going to call it as backward bearing. So forward bearing is in the forward direction of a line. So the bearing is going to be measured with respect to the magnetic north. We are going to be called as a, so forward bearing of a line, theta 1 degrees and theta 2 degrees is the backward bearing. So I want to know that whether I measured correctly the forward bearing and backward bearing, I have to be get a check in terms of the formula. So backward bearing is equals to forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees, or forward bearing difference and backward bearing is equals to 180 degrees. So this is the formula we are going to be using, that backward bearing equals to forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees, or forward bearing and backward bearing, the difference of the forward bearing and backward bearing is always 180 degrees. In this way, we can able to check that whether you measure the bearings from A to B and from A to B in the forward direction, from A to B in the backward direction will be correct or not. So then in that way, we can able to find out. So the difference of forward bearing and backward bearing should be always should be 180 degrees. Means, so you measured bearings of forward bearing and backward bearing is the right one. Or backward bearing, you are able to get it. I want to check the backward bearing, so then forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. So when I have to use the plus positive sign and when we have to use the negative sign. So positive sign is when we use when your, so the forward bearing is so less than 180 degrees. Your forward bearing is greater than 180 degrees, then you have to use that 180 degree. So less than greater than 180 degrees, then you have to use that the negative sign. So positive sign is your forward bearing is less than 180 degrees. So the positive sign, we are going to be using that your forward bearing is less than 180 degrees. And negative sign, we are going to use your forward bearing is greater than 180 degrees. So this is the check. So this is the check we are going to be using for in the formula backward bearing is equals to forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. So in this way, we are going to be calculating that the forward bearing and backward bearing, and also we have to be checked that whether we measure the bearings of forward bearing and backward bearing is right or not. So this is in the case of whole circle bearing. If your bearings we are going to be measured in the whole circle bearing. If the, suppose you are going to be measuring the, so the bearings in the, so the quadrantal bearing system. So your bearings will be in quadrantal bearing. Bearings measured as quadrantal bearing system. So then your forward bearing equals to north theta 1 degrees east. Northeast. Forward bearing always we have to be measured with respect to the quadrantal bearing is north, south, east, west. So your quadrantal bearing system always will be, so with respect to the north and east, and with respect to the south and east, with respect to the south and west, with respect to the north and west. So always whether it will be measuring from north or whether it will be measuring from south. Not from east and west, always we are going to be measuring from north and south directions. From north and south directions, we are going to be measuring the bearing that we are going to be called as quadrantal system. So suppose your forward bearing is north theta 1 degrees east, so the backward bearing will be, so simply we are going to be, your backward bearing equal to, so simply you are taking that the magnitude of the bearing will be same, 1 theta 1 degrees for the north. So what is the opposite? So the direction is going to be called as south. For east, opposite direction is going to be west. So your backward bearing is south theta 1 degrees. So west equals to your backward bearing. So you can able to check it also. For theta 1 north, east theta 1 degrees, suppose it is 60 degrees. So 60 degrees, your forward bearing is north, 60 degrees east. Your backward bearing will be south, 60 degrees west. In this way, we can able to check it. How we can able to check it? We can able to see that. So forward bearing equals to north, 60 degrees east. So this is your 60 degrees. This is north, east, south, west. So my backward bearing, this is north, this is south, east, and west. This is my backward bearing. So this is my backward bearing. So backward bearing will be, So this is 180 degrees plus this one, means if you take that one, this is 60 degrees. Now your backward bearing equals to north is south 60 degrees, east west. So your, this is your backward bearing is going to be coming in the southwest zone. Your backward bearing, so south 60, so this is 60 degrees. So this is the 60 degrees. Southwest 60 degrees is your backward bearing. This is 180. 180 plus 60 is 240. So 240 is in the, in terms of your whole circle bearing system. So that is the way we are able to calculate the, so the whole circle bearing and quadrantal bearing. And how we are going to calculate it is backward bearing is equals to forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. If the system is given in whole circle bearing, the system is whole circle bearing. So if your forward bearing equals to north east theta 1 degrees, so you are right, backward bearing is south west, opposite directions. Change the directions in the opposite direction and your bearing value is not going to be changed, just same as it is. So south theta 1 degrees, west is your backward bearing. This is in terms of you are going to be measuring that the, so the backward bearing in the, if the quadrantal bearing system will be there. So this is, we are going to be using your forward bearing, you are going to be measured in the whole circle bearing system, then backward bearing is always forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. So where, so your so forward bearing is where you have used the plus sign and where you have used the minus sign. Plus sign we are going to be using your forward bearing is less than 180 degrees. Minus sign using your forward bearing is greater than 180 degrees. Is greater than 180 degrees. So in this way, I can able to calculate the backward bearing once you know that the forward bearing. Similarly, once I know that the forward bearing in the quadrantal bearing system, I can able to calculate the backward bearing, only change the directions, opposite directions, then the numerical value of the bearing will not going to be changes as it is. So that will reduce the backward bearing. So then it is going to be, the next one is going to be called as the, how we have to calculate the included angles. Calculation of included angles. Calculation of included angles. If I know that the forward bearing and backward bearing of individual lines, so then I can able to calculate included angle very easily. Always it is going to be composing of the forward bearing and backward bearing or the forward bearing of the same line itself. Suppose this is north direction, line AB. Line AD. From the point A, from the nearest magnetic needle, from the magnetic north, so AB is one direction and AD is the another direction. So AB I measured as theta 1 degrees. AB is the, so the forward bearing measured as the theta 1 degrees. And AD is the forward bearing measured as theta 2 degrees. AD is the forward bearing, A to D is the forward bearing. So this is the forward direction. So this is in forward direction of AB and AD. So A to B, theta 1 degrees forward bearing theta 1 degrees. So AB forward bearing of AB equals to theta 1 degrees. Forward bearing of AD equals to theta 2 degrees. So I want to measure what is this included angle. So this included angle I am going to be giving as alpha. Included angle I am going to be giving as alpha. So the alpha equals to theta 2 minus theta 1. So theta 2 minus theta 1, that is going to be given as your included angle at A. R alpha is the included angle at A. Included angle alpha is the included angle at A, AB of AD. Or you can say that the angle A. Angle A I am going to be calculating. So from AB to AD, forward bearings is going to be measured. In this way, I can able to get that the angle from the bearings. So this is the one side. If the other side will be there, so now here A to B, B to C, the directions are taken place. A to B is theta 1 forward bearing and A to B backward bearing is theta 2 degrees is backward bearing. Then B to C is forward bearing theta 3 degrees. Now I have to be calculated. So what is the angle between AB and BC? So angle between AB, angle between AB and BC, so I am going to call it as a beta. Angle between AB and BC, I am going to be as a beta. Angle beta equals to, so theta 2 minus theta 3 degrees. Theta 2 is the backward bearing of a line AB and theta 3 is the forward bearing of line BC. In previous case, we saw that both will be in the forward direction. A to B and A to D is the only, both will be in the forward bearings. But in this case, one is backward bearing, another one is forward bearing. So from this, I can able to calculate what is the included angle beta. Beta equals to theta 2 minus theta 3 degrees is going to be called included angle between, so angle between AB and BC. So in this way, I can able to measure the included angle between AB and BC. Here, the combination of previous client backward bearing, next client forward bearing. So the difference of, there is subtraction of previous line for backward bearing and the next client forward bearing. So the difference, so that is going to give us the angle beta or angle B itself. So now after the understanding that what is meant by the forward bearing, backward bearing, and how we can able to measure the included angles from the forward bearing and backward bearing. Now some of you will work out some problems to understand the concept clearly. How I can able to, so find out the forward bearing, once you know that the forward bearing, how I can able to find out backward bearing. If the system is given a whole circle bearing, if the system is quadrantal bearing, if you know that the forward bearing, how we can able to calculate the backward bearing. So we will work at some examples such that we can able to know that the concepts clearly. So first question is, convert the following whole circle bearing to quadrantal bearing system. Convert the whole circle bearing to quadrantal bearing system. So first problem one, whole circle bearing is given as 22 degrees 30 minutes. So this I want to convert. The given by the bearing is whole circle bearing. I want to calculate what is the quadrantal bearing. So what is the quadrantal bearing? Quadrantal bearing equals to, so north, south, east, west. So this is line AB. The whole circle bearing is given as 22 degrees 30 minutes. So then quadrantal bearing is north 22 degrees, because it is going to be measured from north to east 22 degrees 30 minutes east. So this is the quadrantal bearing. The whole circle bearing is going to be given as the problem 22 degrees 30 minutes. So second problem is, so whole circle bearing is given as 170 degrees 12 minutes. So 170 degrees 12 minutes. So 170 degrees 12 minutes means it is going to be coming in the second quadrant. This is 170 degrees 12 minutes. So whole circle bearing. So then I want to get that the quadrantal bearing. So quadrantal bearing is always where I had to be measured from south to east. So quadrantal bearing is always I had to be measured from south to east. South to east I had to measure. This is my quadrantal bearing. This is my quadrantal bearing. For that, what I am doing is, so quadrantal bearing equals to 180 degrees minus WCB, whole circle bearing. So quadrantal bearing is 180 degrees, my whole circle bearing is 170 degrees 12 minutes. So what is your quadrantal bearing? Nine degrees 48 minutes. So 9 degrees 48 minutes. So the direction is southeast. So total 180 minus your whole circle bearing. This is the formula we are going to be using. 180 minus WCB. So that we are going to be getting 9 degrees 48 minutes. What is the direction? South to east is the direction. Next, third problem, WCB equals to whole circle bearing equals to 211 degrees 54 minutes. So this is 211 degrees. This is the whole circle bearing. Now I have to be calculated what is this theta. So theta is always is going to be giving as your quadrantal bearing system. Your theta will be south to west. So theta is always south to west. So how I can able to calculate it? So your total is going to be called as, so now your quadrantal bearing is 211 minus 180. Quadrantal bearing is 211 degrees 54 minutes minus 180 degrees. Or the formula quadrantal bearing equals to WCB minus 90 degrees. So that is 211 degrees 54 minutes minus 180 degrees. 31 degrees 54 minutes. 31 degrees 54 minutes. So your theta is south, 31 degrees, 54 minutes west. So this is the way we are going to be calculating that WCB is 2154 degrees. This is 211 degrees 54 minutes. This is known as the theta, is known as the quadrantal bearing. For that, I am going to be using the whole circle bearing minus 180 degrees. That will be used that 31 degrees 54 minutes in which quadrant? This is south to west. South to west. South to west. So in this way, we can able to calculate. Then fourth problem is WCB equals to 327 degrees 24 minutes. So this north, south, and east, 327 degrees. So 327 means it is in the fourth quadrant. This is 327 degrees 24 minutes. 327 degrees 24 minutes. Now I had to be calculated what is this theta. Theta is given as quadrantal bearing for 327 degrees 24 minutes of whole circle bearing. So now here quadrantal bearing equals to 360 degrees minus WCB. My quadrantal bearing, how I can add 360 degrees minus, so whole circle bearing up to this one, I can able to get this one, 360 minus theta. So this quadrantal bearing is 360 degrees minus whole circle bearing is 327 degrees 24 minutes. So quadrantal bearing is 32 degrees 36 minutes. What is the quadrant? North and west. The quadrant is north and the west is the theta. So I am only keeping north and west. So my quadrant bearing is north 32 degrees and 36 minutes the west. So your whole circle bearing is 327 degrees 24 minutes in the fourth quadrant. So then the quadrantal bearing is north to west 32 degrees 36 minutes. So this is the formula using a 360 degrees minus WCB. Or if you know that the geometry easily, circle geometry, the total is 360 minus theta. So 360 minus whole circle bearing, that you are going to get as a theta. Similarly, now we worked out the problem. If the system is given in the whole circle bearing, so how we are going to be calculating that the quadrantal bearing. Now the system of the bearings is going to be given quadrantal system. How we can able to calculate the whole circle bearing system? Convert the following quadrantal bearing to WCB. Convert the following into quadrantal bearing system into WCB. So first problem is, so quadrantal bearing is given as north 12 degrees 24 minutes east. North 12 degrees 24 minutes east. So this is given north to east 12 degrees 24 minutes. Now my WCB also equals to quadrantal bearing. The WCB also 12 degrees 24 minutes. My WCB whole circle bearing also 12 degrees 24 minutes. In the first quadrant, your whole circle bearing and quadrantal bearing will be the same. It is not going to be changes. So 12 degrees 24 minutes north to east, and my whole circle bearing is 12 degrees 24 minutes. Second problem, quadrantal bearing is south 31 degrees 36 minutes east. 31 degrees 36 minutes east. So southeast is going to be called as second quadrant. So this is given as 31 degrees 36 minutes. So southeast 31 degrees 36 minutes. Now I had to be calculated what is this theta. Pole circle bearing is from north direction I am going to be measuring. That's why theta value is going to be from north. I am going to be measuring for this line. So A to B, the direction A to B, line direction A to B, and measure from theta. Now this is given as 31 degrees 36 minutes is your, so the quadrant bearing system. Now I have to be calculated. So what is the WCB? So WCB equals to 180 degrees minus this one, 180 degrees minus quadrant bearing, 180 degrees minus quadrant bearing. So that is 180 degrees minus quadrant bearing is 31 degrees 36 minutes. 148 degrees 24 minutes is the, so now theta value is this one. So theta value is, so total is 180 degrees. 180 degrees minus this quadrant bearing I am detecting now. I can able to get that what is the whole circle bearing of the given one. 148 degrees, so 24 minutes. Now the third problem. Quadrant bearing is south 68 degrees 6 minutes west. 68 degrees 6 minutes west, southwest. So this is given, southwest is given 68 degrees. Six minutes. So this, now I have to be calculated what is this theta. I have to be calculated, this is the whole circle bearing for the line AB. So I know that what is the quadrant bearing. This is 68 degrees 60 minutes. This one is 68 from here to here is 68 degrees 6 minutes, but I have to be calculated from here to here. So what is the whole circle bearing? So whole circle bearing, what is going to happen? 180 degrees plus 68 degrees 60 minutes. So that's the whole circle bearing equals to 180 degrees plus quadrant bearing system. So 180 degrees plus quadrant bearing is 68 degrees 6 minutes. So 248 degrees 6 minutes is the whole circle bearing. And for your, so the quadrant bearing is given as south 68 degrees 6 minutes, southwest is given the problem, and the formula I used is 180 degrees plus QB, means 180 degrees here plus this your quadrant bearing, you are going to be getting that, so your whole circle bearing. So fourth problem, so quadrant bearing equals to north 5 degrees 42 minutes, north 5 degrees 42 minutes west. This is 5 degrees, 42 minutes. But I had to be calculated from here to here. What is this theta value? So 5 degrees, 42 minutes is, this one is given as quadrantal bearing. So now I had to be calculated whole circle bearing of 5 degrees, 42 minutes west. So what I have to do is, total is 360 degrees. 360 degrees minus 5, this quadrantal bearing is going to be getting at the quad whole circle bearing. Now, whole circle bearing equals to 360 degrees minus your quadrantal bearing. So 360 minus this one, you are able to get that the whole circle bearing. This one is going to be called a quadrantal bearing. So 360 minus quadrantal bearing is 5 degrees, 42 minutes. 354 degrees, 18 minutes is your whole circle bearing. Your quadrantal bearing is given as northwest in the fourth quadrant. And how I can able to calculate it? 360 minus your quadrantal bearing, that we are going to be getting that the resultant bearing is going to be called as WCB, 354 degrees, 18 minutes. So in this way, we are going to be so converting. If the system is given as quadrantal bearing system, how I can able to calculate whole circle bearing? If the system is given as whole circle bearing, how I can able to calculate in the quadrantal bearing system? Both. So we are going to be using with the geometry or otherwise simple formula. By using the formula, we can able to convert it from one system to the system of the quadrantal to quadrantal bearing system to the whole circle bearing, and whole circle bearing system to the quadrantal bearing system. Now similarly, so we worked out the problem on forward bearing is given, how we are going to be calculating that the backward bearing. Following observed forward bearings of lines, find backward bearing. Backward bearing of the line. So first problem is forward bearing of AB equals to 12 degrees 24 minutes. Forward bearing of AB equals 12 degrees. So now I have to be calculated backward bearing of AB equals to how much? Forward bearing of line AB is what? 12 degrees, 24 minutes. Backward bearing of AB. So we are having the formula. Otherwise, you can draw a diagram. So this is forward bearing of line A to B, 12 degrees, 24 minutes. Now, how do we get the backward bearing? Means this is the backward bearing. So backward bearing of line is, formula we are having, backward bearing of AB equals to forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. Forward bearing equal plus or minus 180 degrees. I had to use plus sign if your forward bearing is less than 180 degrees. If your forward bearing is greater than 180 degrees, I had to use that the negative sign. Here with the given bearing is, forward bearing is 12 degrees 24 minutes, is less than 180 degrees. So that's why I had to use that. So forward bearing is going to be using that the plus sign. So forward bearing is 12 degrees 24 minutes plus 180 degrees. 192 degrees 24 minutes is the 24 minutes is the backward bearing. So your forward bearing is, so less than 90 degrees, then we have to use that the positive sign. If your forward bearing is greater than 90 degrees, you have to use that the negative sign. For 12 degrees, this is the formula. Backward bearing of AB is plus or minus 90 degrees. Or otherwise, we have to see that your forward bearing and backward bearing. So the difference of forward bearing and backward bearing should be 180 degrees. So that is also based on that one, we are going to be calculating backward bearing of a line equals AB forward bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. Second problem, forward bearing of BC 190 degrees 48 minutes. 190 degrees 48 minutes. So here also forward bearing is less than 180 degrees. Use positive sign. So then backward bearing of BC equals to forward bearing plus 180 degrees. Forward bearing is 190 degrees 48 plus 180 degrees. 299 degrees 48 minutes. So forward bearing of BC is 190 degrees 48 minutes. So this is less than 180 degrees. Then I had used that positive sign. So your formula will be forward bearing plus 180 degrees. 190 degrees 48 minutes plus 190. So then we are able to get 290 degrees 48 minutes. Forward bearing of CD, third problem, forward bearing of CD is 260 degrees. 266 degrees 30 minutes. So this is 260 degrees 30 minutes is so greater than 180 degrees. Use negative sign. So then you are for backward bearing of CD equals to forward bearing minus 180 degrees. The forward bearing is 260 degrees 30 minutes minus 180 degrees. 86 degrees 36 minutes. So 266 is greater than 180 degrees. I had used that the negative sign. Forward backward bearing of CD is forward bearing minus 180 degrees, 260 degrees 30 minutes minus 180 degrees, 86 degrees 30 minutes. Similarly, if it is given as in the quadrantal bearing system, forward bearing, fourth problem, forward bearing of PQ equals to north 18 degrees 0 minutes east. North 18 degrees 0 minutes east. So forward bearing of PQ. So now backward bearing of PQ equals to, always we had to see that north numerical value is not going to be changed. So only we had to be changed that the opposite direction. For the north, the opposite direction is south. For east, opposite direction is west. So 18 degrees 0 minutes. So this is the very simple way we are able to finding out the backward bearing of the line PQ. So south and west 18 degrees. Similarly, if it is fifth problem, forward bearing of QR equals to south 12 degrees 24 minutes south 12 degrees 24 minutes east. Then backward bearing of QR equals to for the south, opposite direction is north, for the east, opposite direction is west. So then 12 degrees, 24 minutes. The value is not going to be changes. Numerical value of the bearing is not going to be changes. Only we have to be change the directions, opposite direction, south to north, east to west. So your backward bearing of QR line is north 12 degrees, 24 minutes west. Then the sixth problem, forward bearing of RS equals to south 59 degrees 18 minutes west, southwest. So your backward bearing of line RS equals to, for the south, what is the opposite direction? North. For the west, opposite direction? East. And 59 degrees. So in this way we can able to calculate the given forward bearing will be in the quadrant of system. South 59 degrees 18 minutes is given. So then your backward bearing we are going to be writing in the quadrant of bearing system. For the south, opposite direction is north, and for the west, opposite direction is east. The value is not going to be changed. Just 59 degrees 18 minutes, that will be equivalent to the backward bearing of the RS. So in this way we are going to be calculating. So how we are going to converting whole circle bearing into the quadrantal bearing system, quadrantal bearing to the whole circle bearing system. Next one, if the forward bearing of a line given in the whole circle bearing system, how we are going to be calculating the backward bearing? If the forward bearing of a line is going to be given in the quadrantal bearing system, how we are going to be converting, or how we are going to be calculating backward bearing of a line in the quadrantal bearing system? So next class, next session we will be going to be discussing about that there, how we can able to calculate the included angles from the given bearing system, or the given bearing of a line, how we can able to calculate the included angles between the lines. Thank you.